नमस्कार, वेलकम टू वीकली वेदर प्रोग्राम ऑफ इंडिया मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट। इफ़ वी सी द मेन चीफ सिनॉप्टिक फीचर्स ऑफ द लास्ट वीक, इन द लास्ट वीक द वेस्टर्न एंड्स ऑफ द मानसून ट्रफ वाज अलोंग द फुटहिल्स ऑफ हिमालयाज ड्यूरिंग 12th टू 17th ऑफ अगस्त। हाउ एवर इट रीचेज इट्स नॉर्मल पोजिशन ऑन 18th अगस्त एंड द ईस्टर्न एंड्स ऑफ द मानसून ट्रफ वाज अलोंग द फुटहिल्स ऑफ हिमालयाज ड्यूरिंग एंटायर वीक। On 16th of August, a low pressure area has formed over the west central and adjoining northwest Bay of Bengal, which moved towards the interior Odisha, northern parts of the interior Odisha on 17th of August, and on 18th of August, it became the less mark. However, the cyclonic circulation lies over the Jharkhand area on 18th, and this cyclonic circulation reaches over the South Bihar and neighborhood areas on 19th of August. There was a shear zone which was roughly along 20 degree north on 17th August, and a cyclonic circulation lies over the central Pakistan and adjoining West Rajasthan during 17th to 19th August, and a north-south trough was running from the south Chhattisgarh and adjoining south Odisha region to interior Tamil Nadu during 13th to 15th, north south trough was running from the Vidarbha to north interior Tamil Nadu during 16th to 18th of August. If you see the satellite animation of cloud convection of the last week, then it is very clearly visible that there was a moderate to intense convection over the most parts of the East India during many days of the week. There was the moderate to intense convection over the North East India and adjoining Sikkim region during entire week. And there was moderate to intense convection over parts of South Peninsular India and adjoining Central India during some days of the week. In the right hand side, this is the observed rainfall on 12th of August. In the last week, the heavy to very heavy rainfall with extremely heavy rainfall was observed at isolated places over Assam and Meghalaya on 3 days, over sub-Himalayan and West Bengal and Sikkim 2 days of the week, and over Uttarakhand in a 1 day in a week. However, the heavy to very heavy rainfall was reported at isolated places over East Uttar Pradesh, sub-Himalayan, West Bengal and Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Meghalaya, बिहार, मराठवाड़ा, उड़ीसा, उत्तराखंड एंड छत्तीसगढ़ ड्यूरिंग 2 or 3 days ऑफ द वीक। इफ यू सी द ऑब्जर्व्ड रेनफॉल इन द लास्ट वीक, सो इन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड पिक्चर इट इज क्लियरली विजिबल दैट इन द इंटायर नॉर्थ वेस्ट इंडिया एंड एडजॉइनिंग सेंट्रल इंडिया देयर वाज द लार्ज डिफिशियंट ऑफ द रेनफॉल विच इज गिवन इन द येलो कलर, and monsoon was weak, means the rainfall was the deficient over the Gangetic West Bengal, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Vidarbha, parts of Maharashtra, Rayalaseema, parts of the Karnataka and Kerala, which is given in the red color. However, West Rajasthan was the dry in the last week, and the monsoon was active over remaining parts of the country. In the right hand side, this is the seasonal rainfall starting from the 1st of June till the 18th of August. Red color means deficient monsoon, which was over the West Rajasthan, Gujarat state, West Uttar Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura, Odisha and Kerala. However, the monsoon was normal over most parts of the Central India, over many parts of the East India and some parts of the Northwest India and entire West India, and some parts of the South Peninsular India also, and including the Andaman Nicobar Island. However, the monsoon was vigorous during the entire season over Gangetic West Bengal, Telangana, Rayalaseema, Tamil Nadu, and North Interior Karnataka. Below, we can see this is the observed rainfall during past week. It's given in the tabular form, so country as a whole, we have received the 39.5 millimeter of the rainfall against the 61.3 millimeter rainfall, which was the 36% below the long period average. एंड इन द लास्ट वीक एक्सेप्ट द ईस्ट एंड नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया ऑल द अदर सब अदर होमोजीनियस रीजन्स रिसीव द बिलो नॉर्मल रेनफॉल. हाउएवर द ईस्ट एंड नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया रिसीव द 3% मोर रेनफॉल अगेंस्ट द नॉर्मल वैल्यू. इन द राइट हैंड साइड दिस इज द रेनफॉल वैल्यू इज गिवन फॉर द एंटायर सीजन. सो ड्यूरिंग दिस एंटायर साउथ वेस्ट मानसून सीजन कंट्री एज ए होल टिल 18th ऑफ अगस्त वी हैव रिसीव द 559 मिलीमीटर रेनफॉल अगेंस्ट द 612 मिलीमीटर रेनफॉल विच इज द 9% लेस रेनफॉल. एंड होमोजीनियस रीजन वाइज एक्सेप्ट द साउथ पेनिनसुलर इंडिया ऑल अदर होमोजीनियस रीजन रिसीव द lesser rainfall as compared to the its normal value. However, the South Peninsular India received the 5% higher rainfall. If we see the today's main synoptic feature, then today the western ends of the monsoon trough is its a normal position, and however the eastern ends of the monsoon trough lies south of its normal position, and it is very likely to shift towards the foothills of the Himalayas during next 3 to 4 days. And today we have cyclonic circulation which lies over the South Bihar. Another cyclonic circulation lies over the East Vidarbha and adjoining South Chhattisgarh in the lower tropospheric level. And a trough is also running from the Gujarat region to Jharkhand region in the lower tropospheric level. We have a offshore trough at mean sea level which is running from the South Maharashtra coast to Kerala coast. So these are the today's main synoptic feature. And if you see the weather forecast and warning for the next 5 days, then the particularly over the northwest India, there will be the enhanced rainfall activity with isolated heavy rainfall during next 3 to 4 days. And there will be the heavy to very heavy rainfall over Uttarakhand during next 2 days, over the east Uttar Pradesh during next 24 hour, and over the west Madhya Pradesh during next 24 hour. After the 4 days, the rainfall will significantly decrease over the northwest India. If we look into the northeast India, then there will be the widespread rainfall with isolated heavy to very heavy falls over the parts of northeast India. However, from 20th of August onwards, there will be significantly reduction of rainfall for the subsequent 3 days. And again, on the 23rd of August and onwards, rainfall will increase over the northeast India. And as far as the East India is concerned, then there will be the fairly wide to widespread rainfall with isolated heavy falls for the next 24 hour. And after the 24 hour, the rainfall will slightly decrease. And in the Central India and adjoining the West India, there will be the good amount of rainfall for the next 2 days. After the 2 days, the rainfall will slightly decrease over parts of Central India and adjoining West India. And as far as the South Peninsular India is concerned, there will be the isolated heavy falls over the Kerala during 21st to 23rd of August and over the Tamil Nadu region during the 21st and 22nd of August. And in the upcoming week, there is no probability of cyclone formation over the North Indian Ocean during the next 2 weeks. However, a low pressure area is likely to form over northwest and adjoining west central Bay of Bengal off north Andhra Pradesh and south Odisha coast during first half of the second week. If we see the weather forecast for the week 1 and week 2, so in this picture it is clearly visible that there will be the significant good amount of rainfall will occur over most part of the country in the week 1 except Jammu and Kashmir, parts of Punjab, Rajasthan and parts of Gujarat state. However, in the other parts, there will be the significant good amount of rainfall. Similarly, in the week 2 also, there will be the significant good amount of rainfall we will receive, except the Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, parts of Gujarat state and parts of Tamil Nadu and parts of West Uttar Pradesh. If you see rainfall anomaly in the week 1 and week 2, then in the week 1, that is from the 20th of August to 26th of August, there will be the above normal rainfall over many parts of the Maharashtra, southwest Madhya Pradesh, parts of the Gujarat state, पार्ट्स ऑफ द ईस्ट यूपी एंड एडजॉइनिंग बिहार, पार्ट्स ऑफ द नॉर्थ राजस्थान एंड सम पार्ट्स ऑफ द साउथ पेनिनसुलर इंडिया इन द वीक वन, एंड देयर विल बी द बिलो नॉर्मल रेनफॉल ओवर द पार्ट्स ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया, सम पार्ट्स ऑफ द सेंट्रल इंडिया एंड सम पार्ट्स ऑफ द जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, एंड हाउ एवर इन द अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री देयर विल बी द नॉर्मल रेनफॉल. इन द वीक टू देयर विल बी द अबव नॉर्मल रेनफॉल ओवर पार्ट्स ऑफ द सेंट्रल इंडिया एंड एडजॉइनिंग वेस्ट इंडिया, एंटायर ऑल अलॉन्ग द वेस्ट कोस्ट एंड पार्ट्स ऑफ द साउथ पेनिनसुलर इंडिया. देयर विल बी द नॉर्मल रेनफॉल ओवर द साउथ इंटीरियर कर्नाटका, तमिलनाडु रीजन, उड़ीसा, बिहार, गैंजेटिक वेस्ट बंगाल, झारखंड एंड वेस्ट उत्तर प्रदेश, उत्तराखंड एंड हिमाचल प्रदेश. हाउ एवर देयर विल बी द बिलो नॉर्मल रेनफॉल ओवर पार्ट्स ऑफ द जम्मू डिवीजन, पार्ट्स ऑफ द हिमाचल प्रदेश एंड पार्ट्स ऑफ आसाम एंड मेघालय इन द वीक टू. इफ यू सी द वेदर फोरकास्ट फॉर द वीक वन, देन देयर विल बी द एज वी हैव सीन देर इज ए साइक्लोनिक सर्कुलेशन विच लाइज ओवर द साउथ बिहार विच इज वेरी लाइकली टू मूव स्लाइटली वेस्टवर्ड्स फॉर द सब्सिक्वेंट थ्री डेज, एंड द मानसून ट्रफ पर्टिकुलरली द वेस्टर्न एंड्स ऑफ द मानसून ट्रफ इज लाइज इन इट्स नॉर्मल पोजिशन एंड द ईस्टर्न एंड्स इज वेरी लाइकली टू शिफ्ट टूवर्ड्स फुटहिल्स ऑफ द हिमालयाज फॉर द नेक्स्ट थ्री डेज. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दीज एक्टिविटीज देयर विल बी द ग्रेजुअल इंक्रीज इन रेनफॉल एक्टिविटी ओवर मोस्ट पार्ट्स ऑफ द नॉर्थ वेस्ट इंडिया एंड बिहार फॉर द नेक्स्ट थ्री टू फोर डेज. इफ यू सी देयर विल बी द फेयरली वाइड टू वाइड स्प्रेड रेनफॉल विद आइसोलेटेड हैवी फॉल्स ओवर बिहार, उत्तराखंड एंड ईस्ट उत्तर प्रदेश फ्रॉम 19th ऑफ अगस्त फॉर द सब्सिक्वेंट थ्री डेज, एंड ओवर द हिमाचल प्रदेश, ईस्ट राजस्थान, वेस्ट उत्तर प्रदेश एंड एडजॉइनिंग एरियाज फ्रॉम 20th ऑफ अगस्त फॉर सब्सिक्वेंट थ्री डेज, एंड देयर विल बी द आइसोलेटेड हैवी फॉल्स ओवर द तमिलनाडु, केरल एंड साउथ इंटीरियर कर्नाटका ड्यूरिंग द 21st टू 23rd ऑफ अगस्त विद आइसोलेटेड हैवी फॉल्स. हाउएवर इन द अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द पेनिनसुलर इंडिया देयर विल बी द लाइट टू मॉडरेट रेन ओवर सम पार्ट्स, एंड इफ यू सी देयर विल बी द फेयरली वाइड स्प्रेड रेनफॉल विद आइसोलेटेड हैवी फॉल्स ओवर द मध्य प्रदेश, कोंकण गोवा, मध्य महाराष्ट्र एंड गुजरात रीजन फॉर द थ्री डेज, एंड देयर विल बी द आइसोलेटेड हैवी फॉल्स ओवर द छत्तीसगढ़, उड़ीसा, झारखंड एंड इवन द तेलंगाना एंड कोस्टल आंध्र प्रदेश फॉर द नेक्स्ट 24 आवर, एंड आफ्टर दैट द रेनफॉल विल सिग्निफिकेंटली डिक्रीज ओवर दोज एरियाज. एंड इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया द ऑनगोइंग हैवी रेनफॉल एक्टिविटी इट्स आइसोलेटेड प्लेसेस एंड द लाइट रेन एट मैनी प्लेसेस विल कंटिन्यू फॉर द नेक्स्ट 24 आवर, एंड आफ्टर दैट द रेनफॉल विल डिक्रीज सब्सिक्वेंटली फॉर द 2 to 3 डेज, and again from the 22nd of August there will be the increased rainfall activity over parts of the northeast India. If we see in the week 2, then the monsoon trough will be near normal position during most days of the week 2, and there will be the we will receive the good amount of rainfall in the week 2 also over the many parts of the country, but in the week 2 there will be the slight reduction in rainfall over many parts of the country as compared to the week 1, and there will be the widespread rainfall with isolated heavy falls all along the west coast parts of the north peninsular India and adjoining central India over most days of the week 2, and there will be isolated light rainfall over the many parts of the northwest India and remaining parts of the northwest India. There will be the clear sky conditions. So overall, the normal to above normal rainfall activity is likely over the south peninsular India and adjoining central India, and near normal rainfall activity likely over most parts of the east and northeast India, and below normal rainfall activity will be over the northwest India in the week 2. You can also download our Mausam app, Damini app and Meghdoot app for the location specific forecast, lightning alert and agro advisory services. You can also follow us on our Facebook page, Twitter page, and our YouTube channel for more detailed weather information in your area. Thank you.